Well, the families of the 298 people lost in the Malaysia Airlines crash are still dealing with that immediate shock and, of course, the grief of this tragedy. In time, though, many will likely seek answers from a court about who is responsible. Floyd Wisner joins us now. He is an aviation accident attorney. He has represented families of victims in several major air disasters. Thanks for being with us, Floyd. And first and foremost, I understand you have a personal connection to this tragedy, and we just want to offer our condolences. Our thoughts and prayers with you. A friend of yours lost two family members, is that right?
That is right. Thanks so much for saying that. My good friend lost two nephews in this disaster.
It's just the details of this so upsetting, and families still trying to process what exactly happened, and inevitably they will likely seek some sort of legal action. And I understand Malaysia Airlines, they have offered families $5,000 for any immediate expenses. Is that fairly typical? Is that to thwart future lawsuits?
Well, no, it's not enough to stop future lawsuits. And Malaysia Air apparently is learning something from Malaysia Air 370. It's now offered at least this token immediately. It didn't even do that before. But that's just a drop in the bucket. It's not going to do anything. And, well, first of all, no compensation can solve this or bring these poor people back. But the families are entitled to compensation. They've lost, many of them have lost wage earners. They need compensation. They're entitled to it.
How does that work, though, when it's not something that's like an accident that the airline could be responsible for? All the evidence pointing to this plane being shot down by pro-Russian rebels. So what will that mean for any possible lawsuits against the airline?
Yeah, that's a good question. But actually, the airline is going to be responsible. They're going to be responsible for paying full damages, in my view. And that is because it's an international flight. It's governed by the Montreal Convention, the case against the airlines, that is. And the Montreal Convention provides that Malaysia Air will have to pay the first $150,000 to each passenger without regard to liability. Thereafter, they will pay additional amounts, uncapped, unless Malaysia Air can show that it took all necessary measures to avoid this loss. I don't think it can show that because it was flying over this airspace when it knew or should have known about the danger. So even if it's 1% responsible, it's going to be responsible for paying all compensatory damages to these people.
And you make a good point about that airspace. That could be specifically what they're pointing to. Let's talk about Malaysia Airlines. I mean, this is the second air tragedy in just 6 months. A lot of people wondering, you know, there are likely lawsuits that are going to be associated with Flight 370 and whether or not this airline is going to be able to survive and remain viable. I mean, it's a state-run airline. That's something that people will have to keep in mind.
Well, you're right. You know, it has insurance, but I guess a good question is, should it survive after bungling two major operations such as this? I mean, why was it flying in this airspace? Mm-hmm. And you would think Malaysia, after what just happened to Malaysia 370, would be so cautious about safety and security. They would do everything possible, and they didn't. I just don't understand it. Maybe they don't deserve to be an airline.
Do you think it's possible that they can survive? And I do want to talk about that airspace because other airlines, I understand, they will avoid those areas, but that takes extra fuel. That's obviously a cost.
Yes.
And you wonder whether or not
Yes.
Flight 370 was a financial burden on them and they were cutting corners.
Well, you wonder about that. Those are all good questions. Other airlines, Qantas, Air China, Korean Air, all were taking different routes, mm-hmm. and yet Malaysia Air was flying this route. Now, Malaysia Air wasn't alone. Others were doing it, too. But you would think that they would be extra cautious, and you do wonder about whether one of these occurrences ties into this next one.
Yeah. Floyd Wisner, so good to have you, and you're obviously going through something very difficult, having a personal connection, so we do appreciate your time. Take care.
Thanks very much.